Buenas noches, mi nombre es Héctor Dorta. Muchos de ustedes me conocen como Junior Salsero de la 91.3. Este es mi programa directo a la comunidad que traigo cada segundo miércoles del mes a través de BCTV Canal 15. Lo pueden ver también a través de bctv.org. Se pueden comunicar con nosotros al 610-378-0426 llamando para hacer preguntas durante la programación. Hoy es miércoles, octubre 11 de 2017. So, estamos en vivo. Si usted quiere hacer una llamada, repito, puede llamar al 610-378-0426 y hacer sus preguntas a mi invitada. Good evening. My name is Hector Dorta. This is Directo a la Comunidad, which is Direct to the Community. It's a program that I bring every second Wednesday of the month from 6:30 to 7. I bring information to the community on education, on different programs in the city, whole bunch of stuff that's happening in the city, good stuff, sometimes bad stuff. And I do it every second Wednesday of the month. If you want to call in, if you have a question for us, we are live today, October 11, 2017. You can call us at 610-378-0426 and do your live calls. Before I start, I want to let the Puerto Rican, the Latino community know, si ustedes todavía quieren cooperar con la isla de Puerto Rico con el huracán María que sucedió dos semanas para atrás, y usted quiere mandar algo a Puerto Rico, estamos buscando cosas de latas, agua, flashlights, baterías, comida en lata, velas, fósforos, porque no se permiten los lighters mandarlos por el correo, poniendo el shampoo, pasta y jabón. Lo puede hacer al señor Rubén y señora Ivette Acevedo. Ellos están en el 618 norte de la calle 8 aquí en la ciudad de Reading. Ellos son de Amazing Kids Daycare en el 618 de la North H. Y le doy las gracias a ellos por lo que ellos están haciendo en estar seguro que esto llegue a Puerto Rico. Otra vez, si quieren llamarlo, el teléfono de ellos es 610-413-5947, o pueden llamar al daycare al 610-375-1945. Con eso vamos a comenzar la programación. My guest today, a great friend, sister, she has a new business that she's opened, and I thought it'd be a good idea to bring her because at the gym where I'm at, we've had it for a while, and I think it's amazing, I think it's important, and I think it's needed. So with that said, my guest, good evening, how are you?
Hello.
And your name?
Rochelle Robertson.
So that everybody knows, I know, but I want everybody to know. La señora Rochelle Robertson, what is your profession?
I'm a professional massage therapist.
Okay. Ella es un profesional en masajes. Vamos a hablar un poquito más de eso entre un ratito. What school did you attend, Rochelle?
I went to Berks Technical Institute.
Okay.
In YMSA.
In YMSA. What made you choose the career?
Well, since I was young, I've always had an interest in the health field and making people feel better and taking care of people. Mm-hmm. So I also work for nursing homes and agencies and things like that. I'm a certified nurse aide as well. So I've always had an interest in, you know, the health field and just how the body works.
Right.
And what, you know, the different muscles and bones and things like that, and making people feel better.
That's good. So then you chose this career.
Yes.
Well, let's talk about the different massages, because a lot of people think that the massage, okay, I'm going to get a massage and that's it. It's not it. There's different massages. And I did a little studying too. And of course, you have yours. There are about like 15 different ones, but we're going to talk about the ones that you personally do.
Mm-hmm.
Let's start with the sports massage. What is the intake of a sports massage?
Well, a sports massage is a little bit different from like a typical regular massage, because there are three different aspects of sports massage. This is more preparing the person for an athletic event.
Okay.
The first thing is like the pre-event.
You're
warming up the muscles, you're getting them prepared and stimulated for an event. And then the next step would be the post-event. And that happens maybe like 1 to 2 hours after the event. And that would be a more light kind of work.
Would technique. That be something that you would have to be there while the event is happening, or is that something where they come, they have the massage of the sport, they go and do the sports, what they're going to do, and then they come back again?
It could be either or.
Okay.
Because I do some events, and I've been at Heart Walls and things like that.
All right.
So it can be either or.
So you would be hired by the client to be there with him on his...
Yes.
Let me explain. El primer masaje, estamos hablando el masaje de deporte. Hay muchas personas que softball, volleyball, hockey, fútbol, pelota, muchos diferentes deportes que hay. Y entonces hay algunos deportes donde se necesitan trabajar un músculo, trabajar un tendón. Y ella también es especialista en esto para esas personas que quieren tener esos masajes para poder seguir haciendo sus deportes. Algunas veces uno llega a la edad como yo, que tengo 55, y voy a algo y cuando termino estoy embaratado, con dolor en todos los músculos. So ese es el deporte, el mensaje de deporte. So in other words, activities like, would that entitle high schools, or is it more like college or more older college students? Or
high school age is okay.
Mm-hmm. Is there an age where, like if somebody was going to get a massage, I guess they'd have to get parental if they're over 18.
If they're under 18.
So that entitles a sport massage, and somebody would hire you, and then you would either go there, or they would even come to your place.
Come
and
to
get
my facility,
okay.
Yes.
All right. Mm-hmm. The other one, which is hard for me to explain, it's reflexology. Now tell me, what does that entitle?
Reflexology, as I have it on my card, is it's actually an add-on service if it's something that you want to include during the session,
right,
or
so
at
the
end of the session. Basically, that's really pinpointing the different pressure areas that actually are connected to the organs, the different organs in your body.
Right.
So that those are basically your hand, in your hands, and your feet. It could be your ears. Yeah. Sometimes on your head, your sinus pressure areas.
In your body.
Yes,
those are very important when it comes to massage therapists. En este, no sé cómo es en español, pero en este masaje es bien importante porque esto, encima del masaje que te van a dar, ella también va a apuntar en los sinuses, que es los sinusitis, las orejas, puntos en el cuello, puntos en los brazos, en la muñeca, en los dedos. Son masajes puntualmente a esa sección del cuerpo. How about the Swedish? Everybody's the most popular one. Everybody talks about the Swedish massage. What
Swedish
is
more of a therapeutic massage. It's more of relaxation.
Nothing really hard.
Nothing real deep.
To just relax.
Yes.
Relax
more of
yourself.
A relaxation techniques. Basically using my hands, my arms, long gliding strokes.
Right.
You know, just more of a relaxation.
Something for me after I have a major asthma attack.
That would be good.
Be an idea.
Yes.
El Swedish es un masaje bien, bien suave. Algo donde ella pasa solamente las manos por diferentes músculos del cuerpo, tendones, nervios. Pero no es nada tan fuerte como el deep tissue que donde están explotando. Esto es algo bien suave, algo sensual. Pregnancy. That one right there, like when I first found out and I wrote it, I said, wait, that looks interesting. Now, a woman, gets pregnant. Most of the time, I've never heard of a woman... But it makes a lot of sense.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking, you know what? That makes a lot of sense. A massage therapist could do a lot for a woman that's pregnant.
Yes.
Tell me in pregnancy, what would that...
for pregnancy, they really should get a permission from their doctor.
Right.
Because it depends on how far along they are.
Okay, trimester.
And with the therapist, whoever is doing the massage, they need to know what areas to avoid as far as a massage for a pregnant woman.
Okay.
Also, we have different tables sometimes for pregnant.
I've seen that because I told you at the gym, we've seen there's three different tables they use.
Yeah. So there can be, we have certain tables that are used for pregnancy massage that maybe there's a hole in the table where their belly can rest.
Mm-hmm.
I don't personally have that because I don't have a lot of pregnancy clients.
But I'm thinking even if you didn't, there's a lot of things that you can do with them.
Oh, definitely. What we can do, I usually prop them with pillows, have a pillow between their legs, one underneath their stomach, one under their head, and I work on their back that way because at
that's
that point...
That's very painful.
Yeah, because some people
when I know from my two daughters and then from... I think they experience a lot of pain in the back, and I would think it would be logical. I mean, they're not going to go to a chiropractor during that time.
Yes.
But going to a massage therapy, for me, it makes a lot of sense.
Yes, because, you know, their body is going through a lot.
A lot of changes.
A lot of changes, and this helps to relax. This helps to take some of that stress It's also been proven to help with like preterm birth, things like that.
It helps a whole lot to relax. I mean, it makes sense. You make it relax, it's going to go through the whole term.
Exactly.
Vamos a hablar un poquito del masaje de cuando una mujer está embarazada. Ella dice que es algo primeramente que tiene que estar aprobado por su doctor o su doctora. Y cuando es probado, en esa situación algo bueno donde ella pone la almohada debajo del estómago, entre medio de las piernas, y es algo para relajar. Porque yo, lo que ella me explica a mí es que mucho cuando una mujer está embarazada es algo muy tenso. Algunas mujeres se sienten incómodas por la espalda, se sienten incómodas por el estómago, la espalda, los dolores. Y esos masajes son bien buenos. Ayuda a la mujer cuando está embarazada en relajarla. Y dicen que cuando hacen esto, ayuda mucho. La mujer entonces llega a los 9 meses para tener su bebé. Déjenme recordarles que si ustedes quieren llamar y hacer una pregunta, estamos al 610-378-0426. I want to remind everybody, this is a live show today, October 11, 2017. You can ask any questions to Rochelle at 610-378-0426. Let's keep going. Deep tissue. Every time when I was at the gym and this girl did, everybody came out like limping or coming out one side quick. Deep tissue. I mean, they say it's really, really, like, it really gets intense.
Deep tissue really focuses on the deeper layer muscles and the tendons and stuff. And so you really have to really get into some of those areas depending on what issues that person has going on.
Let me ask you a question. I've seen them go and I've heard the term, I have knots in my back and I need a deep tissue because there's knots. What are they talking about? Knots.
Those are built up. It's called fascia.
Okay.
Fascia muscles built up tension that has, you know,
like
built up over a period of time.
Right.
You know, we any kind of activity you do or work, say you're sitting at a computer, you're hunched over, you know, you get these knots in your back, things like that. It's built up tension, fascia, and it takes a while for that to break down and the toxins in your body and things like that. You might heard a massage therapist say that before, and that's why it's important after that to drink a lot of water.
And I've seen it because his name is Mr. White, and he's a trainer, and he used to go in and he'd say, feel this, and I used to feel like a knot, like a lump on his back, and then he'd come out and it was gone. And he used to tell me that she just kept working on it. And I heard that. Drink a lot of water.
Yeah, some people don't do that. And you can tend to feel really crappy after a massage if you don't. It's very important. And the therapist should stress that, to drink plenty of water. Because that helps flush out all of the junk that we've been manipulating in there and working on. It needs to go somewhere. So drinking the water helps flush all of that. The toxins and stuff out of your body.
Well, this is nuts. What are the different products that you use to do? Let me just explain this one, Chris. Tal deep tissue. El deep tissue es para entrar bien hondo al músculo, al tendón, a los nervios, y es un masaje donde tiene mucha presión. Algunas personas trabajan, se mantienen con dolor en la espalda en el trabajo o en deportes o lo que sea. Llegas cansado y por tiempo se te montan unas bolitas en la espalda, en los brazos. Y eso, pues, lo que pasa es que ella coge y le da bien duro a los masajes con eso. Y eso, pues, va rompiendo y rompiendo. Y eso, pues, cuando termina todas esas bombitas y eso que hay, pues, ayuda con este tipo de masaje. Let's go. Now that we've talked all of this, we were just, what are the different products that you use for massage? What are the different? I know there's like, I remember the smells because I used to, then with my asthma, I used to walk in, I had to walk out. I used to smell like a mint. I used to smell all kinds of mint.
Different.
Yeah, and then she had different stuff on there.
She might have been using, and that is what a part of aromatherapy.
Okay.
Sometimes the different oils, essential oils.
Oh, that's why the aromatherapy now.
Yes.
It's different oils.
There's
okay.
a different essential oils that sometimes the therapist uses to help relax, stimulate, and you know, whatever, you know, to prepare in the room.
Uh-huh.
Now, that's something that people can ask for.
Okay.
It doesn't necessarily, you don't necessarily have to use that. I use a typical like biotone massage cream because it's more soluble.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't soak into the skin. You know, it's very good for massage.
Right.
And I don't use oil that much.
Right. Is there a lot of people maybe allergic like I am?
Yeah, and there might be certain things, and like I used to use an almond like massage cream, and I found out someone was allergic to almonds.
Wow.
So, you know, you got to be very careful.
Well, there was some there, too, that didn't smell like anything. It was just the paste.
Yeah.
And, that's amazing.
So sometimes it's best to use just plain like massage cream because a lot of people have skin allergies and things like that.
Before a customer comes to you, you, I'm sure, do a questionnaire to get all the information.
I do. I have, and that's part of it with what I just told you. Mm-hmm. I have a, I always ask people to come, especially if it's their first time, to come 15 minutes ahead of time.
Right.
And I have them fill out a paper, which asks them a lot of medical questions.
Right.
Ask what kind of medications they're on, if they're under a doctor's care, if they have any issues as far as their in their muscles, if they had injuries, past injuries, because that lets me know how to work on them and what type of massage they would need.
Mm-hmm.
If they're allergic to anything, things like that.
They need to let you know.
So all of those things, and there's also a picture on the last page of the muscles, and I'll ask them to circle where you're having issues.
Problems. That's great.
What are your problems? And then I meet with them after that, and we talk about it before we go into session.
That's good. You know what? Before we run out of time, I want to make sure. So let's talk about where is your business?
My business is on 2100 Stayhill Road in Wyomissing, PA.
Okay.
And they can also go to my website, rrtherapeutics.com.
Okay, rrtherapeutics.com. Okay.
610-373-2662 is where they can call to make an appointment with me.
That's great. So, and let me ask you, how difficult was it? Because we've known each other for at least 15 years.
Yes.
And I know that you're a go-getter. I was so happy when you told me that had happened.
Yes.
How difficult was it to start your own business?
I've been in business for almost 20 years, and I have gone to different places.
Right.
And I decided to step out on my own. Before this opportunity came up, I was doing it out of my home and going to people's homes as well.
Okay.
And I still do that every now and then. But this came up, and I decided to go for it.
Absolutely.
And I'm loving it. It's this Friday will be a year that I've been open for business.
That's
and so I'm loving it. It's still a learning process. It's a lot involved with running a business.
Sure, it is.
So I'm still learning, but I have great people that I can go to advice.
And one thing I want to do before we go, I want to explain to TV viewers, before that, let me explain. Para la persona, ella abrió su negocio, ya va para un año que tiene su negocio. Ella lleva más de 10 años haciendo, pero ahora lleva como un año haciendo este negocio. Lleva muchos años haciéndolo, no en un negocio, pero yendo a casa, en diferentes sitios. Ahora por fin abrió su negocio. My question is, I want to clear this with my viewers.
Yes.
Most people think massage, they think of a total unprofessional thing.
Mm-hmm.
You went to school, you're certified, and this is a total professional profession where you have your business, people go.
Yes.
And I wonder my viewers, because in other shows or other things, you know, they start thinking and they need to know that it is a very professional, women can go, men can go. Even kids, if the parents bring them, it's a professional business.
Yes.
What are your sessions like? What kind of, do you do an hour, half hour? What is it that you offer?
Depending on the client.
Okay.
It depends on what issues they have and what they need.
Okay.
That's how we determine what type of massage, whether it be deep tissue, Swedish, or, you know, some people are like, I don't like a lot of pressure. I just want to relax.
Right.
Then I know, okay, they want the Swedish massage.
Okay.
Some people are like, I really have, like you said, the
knots
or whatever, and it's really, you know, then I know I need to go a little bit deeper. You know, so then I can suggest those things for them. This is why we have the screening to begin with and the forms to fill out so they know that this is a professional business that they're coming to. And, you know, a lot of medical, you know.
Yes, issues. People with medical issues.
Yeah, issues.
Yes.
You know, people with medical issues mostly come, you know, with me.
Quiero informarles, esto es un negocio bien profesional. Mucha gente oye masaje y piensa lo negativo. Es un profesional. Ella estudió años y lleva años haciéndolo. Es una profesión. Quiero darle el teléfono para esas personas que quieren hacer el appointment. Es el 610-373-2662. Repito, 610-373-2662. Ella se llama Rochelle. la pueden llamar y hacer su appointment para esas personas que le interesan. Let's repeat one more time. The name of the business.
The name of the business is R&R Therapeutics.
R&R, and the address one more time.
Is 2100 Stahel Road
and
in Wyomissing,
PA. Phone number in English.
610-373-2662.
I want to thank you for coming in. See, I told you it went by quick, and we give a lot of information.
Yes.
And people now know that if you want a professional and you need a massage, and you can go to Rochelle. I guarantee you, she's like my sister. She's wonderful, and I love her and her husband, Wayne. We've been friends for years, and this is a new venture for her, and I hope that you support her. Before I go, I want to remind you all, there has been tragedy I've never seen in my life. The devastation in Puerto Rico. I'm seeing it now because people are going to the inner island. And I have family there, and it hurts watching the first few days. But now watching now, it hurts me more than ever. And I know that I have this faith with God that I know things are going to be okay. But it's difficult for me to see what's going on. So if you want to help and you want to send water, again, we need water, we need flashlights, we need batteries, canned foods, candles, matches, because they don't allow lighters on planes or anything, shampoo, toothpaste, toothbrushes, brushes for hair. You can take these to Ruben and Yvette Acevedo. They're at 618 North 8th Street. You can call them at 610-413-5947, or you can call the business at 610-375-1945. This is going to be, I think, a thing that we're going to have to do together. I'm not here to talk about the government. I'm not here to talk about Red Cross. I'm here to say that we need to have a positive attitude to make our country come back again. I want people to understand, and it's sad, some people didn't know that Puerto Rico was part of the United States. It is a Commonwealth of the United States, folks, and I'm Puerto Rican. I was born there, but I'm an American too. And we need to help our Americans. They're there. They're suffering. Believe me, they need water. They need food. They need a lot of things. So if you can, whichever way you want to do it, I'm just giving you an idea now. I know Ruben. I know Yvette Acevedo. They're very good people. And they're going to make sure they've already sent one container, and they're working on sending the other one. So I highly recommend, I'll repeat the number again. Their personal number is 610-413-5947. And their daycare, their business is 610-375-1945. Lo repito una vez más. Le quiero dar las gracias a Rubén y a Vera Acevedo. Ellos tienen el container que van a mandar para New Jersey, de New Jersey a Puerto Rico. Ellos están en el 618 de la norte de la 8. Puedes llevar lo que tú quieras. Agua, flashlight, baterías, comidas en lata, velas, fósforos, shampoo, pasta de diente y cepillo de diente y cepillo de pelo. I want to thank everybody for another show. My name is Hector Dora, Directo a la Comunidad. Remember, every Thursday from 7 to 12, 91.3 FM, the best in salsa. Thank you so much, Rochelle.
Thank you.
Okay. Everybody, we'll see you next week. God bless.